Welcome to this long-form overview of Your Climate Toolbox. The climatographers have been working in the climate change field for more than 30 years, and we've come to see that the information that would influence anyone's thinking about climate change is out there, but most people are unlikely to ever see the information that would influence their thinking, and they're unlikely to ever see some of the best books and the best ideas and the best websites. And so we've pulled all of that together into a very easy to access toolbox, as I'm going to describe to you in this video. So when you come into the toolbox through toolbox.climatographer.com, you can simply scroll down through the page, which introduces the toolbox. And what you'll eventually see is some hyperlinks to the toolbox roadmap, the toolbox user guide. And I'm going to start with the user guide because it has a useful image for purposes of explaining how the toolbox is working. So basically, each of the thoughts that you see here is in effect a tool in the toolbox. And then all of these thoughts are organized by these sections of the toolbox, whether toolbox mini courses, toolbox courses, tracking climate change. These are the sections. Under them are the tools. Any individual tool might have a lot of resources in it, whether books or videos. There, one particular tool has a series of 80 videos introducing and explaining climate change. So you're getting access here to thousands of resources that we've collected over many, many years. But again, very easy to navigate because all you're really doing is clicking from one thought to another through very easy links in the text, and then going out to look at resources that aren't in the toolbox, they're external links. Then you can come right back into the toolbox and continue your exploration. So one useful thing to remember is that you can return to the front page of the toolbox at any time simply by clicking on the climate toolbox at the top left. Now, there are some other things here. One is pins, which I'll show you in just a second. Types, which you can ignore. Tags, which you can ignore. You can certainly search the toolbox, but it's not really necessary given how simply it is laid out and designed. Over on the other side, you do have the option of seeing that Plex mode, that screenshot that I just showed you, but you don't need to at all. And the default here is the no Plex mode, which is what we're looking at right here. But you can play with it if you want. There are some settings that you can adjust. No need to adjust those at all, but they are there if you ever want to explore them. And if you are a subscriber to the toolbox, make sure that you're actually logged in here. Make sure that it shows you your initials, because it's being logged into the toolbox that will demonstrate all the subscriber, or open up all the subscriber only content for you. So that's a quick overview of what's up there. Let me come back to the pins, because this is the different sections of the toolbox. So we have the roadmap, which I'll show you in a second. Tracking climate change, I'll show you something there. I'll show you something from each of these. Toolbox courses, mini courses, collections, audiences, climate search terms, and then the user guide, which you've already been to, and the what's new, which is basically what are we doing differently? How are we changing the way the toolbox is working? Because it is constantly evolving, and we've made big changes to it since Your Climate Toolbox 1.0 came out. But for right now, let me just jump very quickly to the roadmap. The idea of the roadmap, not surprisingly, is to give you sort of a roadmap. You can walk through here and it tells you a lot about the different sections and some of the key resources, the key tools that you can access, listing some of the courses that you can jump to, some of the mini courses, some of the toolbox collections. So in other words, just through this page, you can jump to many of these resources, and then you can come right back here if you want to and continue going through the roadmap, or you can go wherever you want in the toolbox, knowing that you can get back to this roadmap at any time through the drop-down pins menu. Something that you probably want to visit relatively frequently, the Tracking Climate Change page, and in particular, the real-time monitoring page. And I'm going to open that up. This is an entirely open access page. And it has a video, a video that gets put out every 2 weeks by Yellow Dot Studios on extreme events around the world. An interesting video to watch. Then we have some of the key links that we would recommend for at any given time, seeing what's happening in terms of air temperatures, ocean temperatures, sea ice, coral reef stress levels, all of these things. And you can jump right to them from these links, but you can actually come farther down the page and we actually show you screenshots of what you'll see if you do go to those links. Now, these screenshots are not intended to be today or yesterday. This screenshot is from July of 2024. But if you click on the hyperlink, it will take you to today's version of this resource. And we basically explain what you can do with that resource right here in the hyperlink. Doing the same for Climate Central's Climate Shift Index, a fascinating resource for seeing the anomalies today, whether it's air temperatures, whether it's ocean temperatures, and how much more likely those anomalies are as a result of climate change, at least based on the Climate Central methodology. And so you can come down, do the same thing here for this is land, this is oceans. You can come down here. The Climate Reanalyzer is an amazing tool for being able to come in and you can toggle for ocean, land, averages, max, min temperatures, anomalies, snow, ice cover, potential precipitation. And it's basically up to date in terms of today. And it's an amazing resource for getting a sense of what's going on around the world. You can easily click to Northern Hemisphere, sea ice extent and over time series for all the different years, see where we are today for northern sea ice for this year. Same thing for daily sea surface temperatures. And as you can see, 2023, 2024 have been pretty remarkable years that you've probably seen commented on in the news. Daily surface air temperature, coral reef health, an interesting resource. This is Roger Brugge's inventory. Every month he puts out a list of extreme events that happened during the prior month. And through this link, you can simply go to his collection of the most recent month. And then we have a few other resources that we've included. Another way of looking at sea ice, 2.5 air pollution levels, surface winds, current waves, ocean wave patterns, today's jet stream, other interesting resources, not as specific to sort of a climate snapshot as the rest of this page, but also very useful, very easy to access resources. And so this is just one of the resources available to you on the Tracking Climate Change. You can go and dig much more deeply, and some of these are subscriber access, but much more deeply into what's going on with the trends, with the energy imbalance, with climate forecasting. What are some of the forecasts? You can actually walk through and do your own climate forecasting with the European Copernicus model. We have a mini course that walks you through that. How to interpret a lot of the climate data that is out there, and then a fascinating resource for exploring the global energy system via a series of maps that let you look at, in this case, coal mines, but power plants, geothermal resources, solar installations. You can instantly take a look at all of those things in map format, and we have a bunch of other great resources here for visualizing the energy system as well. And again, this page is entirely open access. So I'm going to click and come down to the Toolbox Courses section. We have lots of courses, and some of our courses, most of our courses, These are not intended to be year-long courses or six-month courses. These are 30-minute, 45-minute courses that you can easily get through, introducing you to some of the great books that are out there, some of the key topics that you might want to know more about, whether it's carbon offsets, whether it's the business and climate change conversation, whether it's the metaphor of climate chess that we've come up with in terms of team urgency and team no urgency, battling it out on a climate chessboard. We also have a lot of mini courses, which are one-page courses that you can walk through for dozens of important climate topics. And then you get into more content, more courses, and I'm just going to click on one of these, which we've put together. And what you can see is here are the different sections of the course. And in the courses specifically, at the bottom of the page is the next section. So if you then go and read through the climate change as wicked problem section of the course, when you get to the bottom of that, you will see a child thought. And in this particular course, we're using quite a few slides, as you can see. But the next section of the course is what do we know and not know? And so then you can just go down through that part of the course. And when you get to the end of it, you'll have the option of going to the next section, which is the fingerprint on climate change. And so you get the idea. You can very easily navigate your way through the different courses. And I'm just going to jump over to the mini courses for just a second. And what you'll see here is just some of the topics that are covered, and we're always adding more topics. And this is content that the climatographers have put together and that we've pulled in from our climate web knowledge solution. A lot of the interesting questions that we've grappled with over the years, we basically put it into a one-page mini course so you can quickly come up to speed on lots of interesting topics. So that's what the mini courses are about. And I'm just going to jump back over and go to Toolbox Collections. Toolbox Collections range pretty widely. So there is a climate risk collection, which points you to some of the best reports, and you can read them right here in the toolbox, starting out with a 2008 report, which is sort of, I would consider it the first real sort of climate risk report intended for a general audience. And then there have been several reports every few years. A couple of books are in here. This is sort of a core climate risk library if you want to take advantage of it. But there are other things. Climate Bookshelf points you to collections of books. Climate Reports, that's the same for reports. Climate Video Collections, I'm just going to go in here and show you How It All Ends is a video series put together by an Oregon high school teacher a number of years ago. It is dated. It was done in 2007, but it remains remarkably current. And if you click on that page, what you'll see is that we've organized all the videos, basically 68 different videos for you. And you can simply watch a video, and then at the bottom of that video will be the next video if you want to go on to that. So you know, here's an example of just one page, but it's pointing you to more than 60 other resources. And you can come back up to climate music videos, video channels, a small selection of sort of must-watch climate videos, and just lots of content of that kind. And you can go down through the collections. There's all kinds of stuff here. We also show you how to dig more deeply into the Climate Web knowledge solution if you want to, which is a massive resource in its own right. You can come down to the climate change, managing climate change misinformation, which is the Skeptical Science website. You may be familiar with Skeptical Science, but it basically addresses all of the different arguments that people are making about climate change that happen to not be true. So, under the guise of climate change is not happening, here are the arguments. And all you have to do is click on any of these links, it will take you to that page in Skeptical Science, and you can read it. And Skeptical Science is a great resource. And in many cases, you can actually choose whether you want a basic or an intermediate or an advanced explanation of this particular topic. So we don't bring the entire database into the toolbox. There's no reason to do that. But we do list the entire contents of the database, making it very easy for whenever you have a couple minutes, you can just pick one of these and go take a look at it. It's a great resource. So again, it's one tool pointing you to how to counter more than 300 of the arguments that tend to get used or thrown around with regard to climate change that unfortunately or fortunately are not true. So that's just some of the collections here. We're always adding more collections, all kinds of stuff here that you can explore and take a look at whenever you have a few minutes to do that on your phone, on your iPad, on your laptop, whatever. So I'm going to come back to the pins. I'm not going to do the toolbox audiences. That is something that is coming soon. The climate search terms is a fascinating resource where we've basically organized thousands of preset search terms. And so you can just see them here. So for each of these things, whether it's climate science or societal risks or climate economics, if I click, for example, on cost-benefit analysis, that will open up the searches, the preset search terms for cost-benefit analysis. And some of them are Google, some of them are YouTube searches, Twitter searches, Vimeo searches, Google Images searches, Google Scholar searches. So we've used different sources, and by activating any of these searches, you will automatically search whether it's YouTube or Google or whatever. And it's a great way of digging deeper into topics and resources. This works particularly well if you've subscribed and downloaded the toolbox to your own computer, because then the searches happen right in front of you. Within the toolbox, you're not going in and out of the toolbox all of the time. All you have to do is hover over the search term, and basically over on the right-hand side, it will display the response to that search. But that's only if you've downloaded the toolbox to your own computer. And then we have the user guide, which I've already shown you, and the what's new. So I've walked you through all of the different main sections. Again, very easy to navigate, an enormous amount of content here. And the idea is not that you have to read this thing from the front to the back or anything like that. The idea is, how can we organize information that might help you come up to speed, because you're interested in climate change, you're concerned about climate change. What is it that you might find particularly useful, and can we organize it in an easy to find way? If you have thousands of hours to spend searching the internet, great. We've done that. We've organized the information for you here. So I hope that's useful. I hope you will visit the toolbox. I would welcome you to subscribe and support our work in continuing to build out the toolbox. It's extremely cost effective to subscribe to the toolbox, because we want it to be available to anyone that is concerned about or interested in climate change. So that is our long form introduction. We also have a short form intro of about 4 minutes that shows you literally what you need to know to navigate. But between the two, I hope that gives you a better sense of what the toolbox is about, and that you'll want to take a look. Thanks.